Good afternoon, everyone. In this short lecture, we are going to learn about an introduction about supervisory control and data acquisition system, that is the SCADA system. SCADA system basically are used for data monitoring and control of any system. But in electrical engineering, its main application is in power system. So let's start. SCADA is an acronym that stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition. Definition of SCADA: a collection of equipment that will provide an operator at remote location with enough information to determine the status of particular piece of equipment or entire substation and cause action to take place regarding the equipment or network. What is SCADA? How it is working, where it is working, and why it is working? By collecting information from plant and load center, band reducing it to the electronic measurement management system. Control center, both at plant and the load center, is there working, and why it is working? To gather information as here is voltage, current, frequency, power, circuit breaker status, and to perform online actions. These are the important parameters of power system which we have to gather from the remote locations. This is voltage, current, frequency, power, and circuit breaker status. SCADA system basically are used to monitor or to control any process in different systems. Evolution of SCADA. Mainly SCADA evolved in the late 1890s, where the first remote control and remote indication starts. Then from the subsequent time, the SCADA systems becoming more and more upgraded, and as per time passes, in modern days, in around 2000 or 2010, energy management system are involved for the controlling of and management of total power system, of overall power system. Objectives of SCADA may are some important objectives of SCADA: monitoring, continuous monitoring of the parameters of voltage, current, frequency, power, etc. Measurement of variables for processing. Data acquisition system, frequent acquisition of data from RTU and data loggers, phaser data and concentrators, etc. Data communication. Through SCADA, we can also communicate various parts of the power system. Transmission and receiving of large amount of data from field to control centers is necessary. Control online, real-time control of for closed-loop and open-loop process. Automation. Automation task of switching off transmission lines, circuit breakers, etc. There are many benefits of SCADA systems, but the few are listing here. The important benefits of energy management system can be addressed as the following functions: continuous monitoring of process, real-time control, automation and protection, remote control and operation. Function of SCADA. There are many functions of SCADA. The important functions of SCADA are listed below: data acquisition, information display, supervisory control, alarm processing, information storage and reports, sequence of event acquisition, data calculation, special RTU processing and control. SCADA in process control. There are many applications of power system, but SCADA is not a specific technology, but a type of application. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition. Any application that get data about a system in order to control that system is a SCADA application. A SCADA application has two elements: the process of or system that needs to be monitored or controlled, a network of intelligent devices that interfaces with the first system that through sensors and control outputs. This network, which is a SCADA system, gives the ability to measure and control specific elements of the first order. One can a SCADA system using several different kind of technology and protocols. So this white paper will help you to evaluate your options and decide what kind of SCADA system is what for. The SCADA system is not for particular application. There are various application modes and ways in which we can use SCADA application. Some of popularly or widely used systems in which SCADA applications are used is electric power generation, transmission and distribution. Water and sewage, building facilities and environments. Facility managers use SCADA to control HVAC, refrigerating units, lighting and entry systems. Manufacturing, SCADA systems manage parts inventories for just-in-time manufacturing and regulate industrial automation and robots and monitor process and quality control. Mass transfer, transit authorities use SCADA to regulate electricity to subways and trams and trolleys buses to automate traffic signals for rail system, to track and locate trains and buses and to control railroad crossing gates. Traffic signals, SCADA regulate traffic lights, control traffic flow and detect out of order signals. Real time monitoring control using SCADA. There are following important features of SCADA from a control point of view. SCADA is applicable to following: acquire qualitative measurement immediately and in over time, detect, diagnose and correct problems as soon as they arrive, measure trend over time and prepare reports and chart, discover and eliminate bottleneck over time and improve efficiency, ability to control large and complex processes with a few specialized staff. So for the use of SCADA, SCADA not only advance in technology but also reduce the manpower quantity in a particular firm or body. So this is a short introduction of SCADA, and this introduction and knowledge and very information about SCADA is available in many books and also available in NPTEL website. Thank you for these are some SCADA system perform four functions: data acquisition, network data communication, data presentation and control. So these are main, not only these are few functions, but SCADA functions perform many functions other than this four main functions. SCADA has also main components about four SCADA components. Sensors are the way and control relays are main components of SCADA system. Remote telemetry units, they are small computerized units deployed in the field at a specific site and locations. Small computerized units at a specific site and location. RTU serves as collection points for getting reports from sensors and delivering command to controls. SCADA master units, there are larger computer consoles that serve as the control central processor for the SCADA system, and master units provide a human interface to the system and would automatically regulate the managed system in response to the sensor units. Communication network that connects the SCADA master units into the RTU in the field. So this is a small introduction about SCADA systems and the SCADA software and internal hardware processes we will learn in next lecture. So hopefully this is very important and very beneficial to you for your exams. Thank you.